So Google Stadia finally came out, and I'm excited. I'm happy with it. I've gotten to spend about a week with the Stadia already, and I've got some thoughts. In particular, I have thoughts about what I see a lot of people saying online, on YouTube, you know, most other communities, where they think the Stadia is competing with consoles. And I wanted to talk about that because I actually don't think it's competing with consoles at all. So here are my thoughts. Very quickly though, I'm actually a console gamer. I had a PS4 for a very, very long time. I actually had several PS4s. I think most of us do. There's so many special editions out now that it's very hard to just have one. But I had several PS4s. I had a bucket full of controllers. And I was actually hosting tournaments as well, so I kind of got to experience the full flavor, the full bouquet of having a console, having a PS4, you know, the experience, the friends gathering around, you know what I mean? Until eventually I felt like I experienced everything I could, and I kind of stepped away from console gaming, but I still wanted to play, I still wanted to have a way to connect with my friends, I still wanted to have a way to, you know, really enjoy myself, have something to do on my spare time. I'm actually a fidgeter, so I need to have something in my hands. I got to be doing something with my hands constantly. So I actually slowly but surely went into mobile gaming, and it was fun. It's a lot of great. The quality of mobile games has really gone up. For example, PUBG, Call of Duty Mobile, those things are huge. So I really got into mobile gaming. I'm still really into mobile gaming, because what I like about mobile gaming is if I want to play PUBG, let's say with my grandma, I can. She's just got to download something and she's in, you know what I mean? Anyone across the world, if I meet somebody, hey man, let's play some video games, you know what I mean? Let's have some fun. They can easily, it's just a download away. There's no paywall, whereas in a console, right away, the cost of entry is a lot of money. And to stay in the game, you have to keep paying and paying. There's just so much money up front for console gaming. That's another reason why I kind of deviated away from it. I was pursuing digital minimalism and really evaluating my assets and my liabilities. And I realized having an expensive hobby like console gaming kind of was just not something that I wanted at the moment. I wanted to focus on my other projects, for example, this channel. I'm into the mobile market now, and what I really like about it is it starts off free. There is in-game purchases, you know, everything's got microtransactions now, but it's not as bad on mobile than it is on console gaming, where a lot of things are just hidden behind paywalls. So going back to Stadia, and then there's PC gaming as well. PC gaming is probably the most expensive, but we won't go there. PC gaming is easily at the top, but it's also one of the most expensive. And then the community is very particular. I was into PC gaming for a little bit. I didn't really enjoy the community as much. I just wasn't mixing with them. So I got out of that as soon as I really just noticed that. But going back to Stadia, a lot of people seem to think the Stadia is competing with consoles like the PS4. It's not. The Stadia is competing with mobile. The reason I feel that Stadia is competing with mobile is because it right out of the box, it goes really well, works really well with a phone. And I love that. I love that because you have your phone everywhere. And then there comes the question like, okay, what about the speeds? What about the data caps? Yeah, well, Google knows that 5G is right around the corner, so they strategically did the Stadia now, and when 5G is out, it's going to be even better. It's already really good. It's going to just be better on mobile after that, connecting to your phone, and this is really, really fun on a phone. I like the idea of playing a AAA title right away from my phone, straight into this, and that's very exciting for me because I can have the experience that I love with a console. But with very little point of entry, like a phone or a browser. I mean, the fact that if I wanted to play with someone like my grandma or someone across the world, they just gotta open a browser. Think about that. That's just great. Not a lot of people have consoles or can afford consoles. They can't just drop in and play with you. Whereas now you just open up a browser and people can just jump in. You know what I mean? That's genius. And a lot of the features on Stadia are still locked under, you know, they're still under development. But that's okay. I'm very excited for this platform as it is right now. But that's the biggest mistake that I see a lot of people making about Google Stadia, is that they think it's competing with consoles or maybe even PC. It's not. It's actually competing with the mobile market. And if you're a mobile gamer, this would actually jive with you a little bit more. And when you think about the overall global gaming market, 50% of that market, 50% of that market is actually mobile gaming. So that's a big chunk, and you can tell it's a big chunk because other companies like Stadia, Sony and Microsoft are actually really trying to tap into these markets with other products, you know, like other streaming products, because they know that the mobile market is huge. At the same time, they don't want to disrupt what they have already, but Google Stadia is already at the forefront with that, and I'm excited. I'm in it for the long run. If you guys agree, disagree, give me a comment. Let me know. I'm new to this kind of stratosphere of creating content, but I am not new to gaming. I'm very well versed in it. Let me know. Leave me a comment. Let me know what your thoughts are, and maybe we can play. Maybe get on there. Tell me your username. I'm looking for a dedicated team to make a clan in Destiny. I'll be very excited to play with you guys. And then, but let me know what you think of the video, okay?